Freeholder Carter.
Present.
Freeholder Estrada.
Present.
Freeholder Granados.
Present.
Freeholder Hudak.
Present.
Freeholder Kowalski.
Here.
Freeholder Mirabella.
Present.
Freeholder Wright.
Present.
Vice Chairman Bergen.
Present.
Chairman Jalloh.
Here.
Chairman, you have 9 freeholders present.
Thank you. Clerk of the Board, can you please lead us in a prayer and salute to the flag?
Humbly we ask God, the giver of peace and the lover of charity, to give the entire family of nations true agreement with his will, and to grant the light of his spirit on all who work for justice and peace.
Amen. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Clerk of the Board, may you please read the Statement of Compliance with the Open Public Meetings Act.
Chair wishes to announce that pursuant to the required statutes annotated, Title 10, Chapter 4, Section 10 of the Open Public Meetings Act, adequate notice of this meeting of the Board of Chosen Freeholders of the County of Union has been given by mailing the annual meeting schedule for the year 2015, along with periodic changes necessitated by circumstances to the newspapers circulating within the County of Union who are designated to receive such notice, and by posting the annual meeting schedule for the year 2015 in the Administration Building, and further by filing the annual meeting schedule for the year 2015 with the Office of the County Clerk.
Thank you. We'll approve the communication at the January 29th regular meeting. We'll start this agenda meeting with the Office of the Union County Prosecutor. See the First Assistant Prosecutor, Tim Eisenhower. How are you?
Good evening, Chairman, members of the Board. Nice to see you up there.
Freeholders, any questions? Vice Chairman Bergen.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. This says that there's a county match of funds.
Yes.
Do those funds, they're coming out of the prosecutor's regular budget?
Yes, they do. They're accounted for in the county budget. I believe it's about $250,000 for, actually, it's a little less this year. I think it's around $211,000 from the grant. The county matches $52,000. There's a slight reduction from last year. It basically pays for the same 6 employees. We have 4 victim witness advocates and 2 clerical employees. I actually was trying to determine why there was a reduction this year, but unfortunately, our grants manager has a serious car accident. She wasn't available. I'll have that information for you by the next meeting. But that $50,000 match is budgeted into our budget, to answer your question specifically.
Thank you.
Anyone else? Thank you. Next up, the Department of Administrative Services. See Mike Yuska, Purchasing Director. How are you this evening?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Welcome aboard and welcome to the helm of the ship. Ladies and gentlemen of the Freeholder Board, the Department of Administrative Services has 6 resolutions for your consideration, and I would be happy to answer any questions.
Thank you. Freeholder Hudak.
Chairman Jalloh, thank you very much. The first resolution, the $1.2 million for Verizon, what was our expense last year?
Last year it was approaching $1.2 million, and just to elaborate a little on this, we're in the process of turning over a lot of the telecommunication systems in the county. I know that you're all aware that we are moving to VoIP. As I understand it, and as Johnson Communications has instructed Norman and myself, the VoIP has to go on all online together. It can't go into little bits and pieces. So this $1.2 million is a worst case scenario for this year. And as soon as we start to realize those savings, we'll be back to the board with those expected happy news, and there will be a considerable reduction in the $1.2 million.
Is there any kind of projection yet?
No, sir. Not that we're aware of.
Thank you, Director.
Else? Thank
you. Number 6 about collision repair, it's number seems large until you realize that it's for 24 months, but I'm wondering, do you have a, do you know how much we've used, we used out of the budgeted amount for the last contract?
Yes, Freeholder. The last contract was for 24 with a 24-month extension, and over those 4 years, the actual spend was $309,000 for 4 years. So again, what we try to do when we award these not-to-exceed figures is worst-case scenario. When I talked to Director Meehan about some of the issues of the costs that we did have a few hit-and-runs. Interestingly enough, we had two hit-and-runs with the trailers that are on the side of the road that tell you how fast you're going. Two of them were plowed into in hit-and-runs, and we had to have this company repair them. But I digress. I'm sorry.
Anyone else? Thank you. Department of Corrections, Director Brian Reardon.
Good evening, Mr. Chairman, members of the board. I have one resolution for your consideration this evening. I'll try to answer whatever questions you have. It pertains to an extension to our existing telephone contract to provide inmate phone services.
Why don't you tell us a little bit about this one? I like this kind of deal where it costs us nothing and we get revenue as well.
That is correct. We've been under state contract with GTL, if I recall correctly, since 2006. It is a revenue-producing contract. We do get a commission of the overall telephone utilization in the jail. The reason why this extension is for such a short period of time is because, to try to sum it up as best I can, we've been under a state contract, but in so much as being under a state contract, each individual county who has opted to go under that state contract and utilize the services of Global Tellink has been able to negotiate their own contracts with GTL. The FCC is rumored to be undertaking some possible changes to the rates and the applicable charges that we can levy against inmate telephone calls, and those changes and or revisions in law are expected to come down pretty shortly. So the state is only giving us a month-to-month ability to extend these contracts. So you may see me up here quite often with this type of a resolution. But, you know, we're, as of right now, we're content with the services of GTL. You may recall that we put out a RFP to solicit services for inmate telephones, jail management system, inmate video visitation, things of those lines. And we're still in the process of evaluating the responses that we got from that. It's a very laborious undertaking. There's a lot of technology involved in that. But in the interim, we're happy with the services that GTL provides to us, and we're happy with the revenue it produces as well.
Thank you. Is any other questions? Thank you, Director.
Thank you.
Department of Economic Development, Deputy County Manager William Reyes.
Good evening, Chairman. Freeholders, the Department of Economic Development has three things on for your consideration. Prepare to answer any questions you may have.
Freeholder Carter.
Director Reyes, can you give some information in reference to number one? Is this a renewal? How much it was last year? Is it anything different, more or less, in purpose of it?
For number one, this is actually a new wash down station. DEP has actually been requiring anybody who has who does more than a few washings of vehicles or equipment to actually have washdown stations. This way, it literally what it is that it is a system where you wash vehicles, or in this case lawnmowers, and the water is recycled so you can wash additional vehicles or equipment and not have any oil or sediments or anything else go into the sewer system. So this is a new system that would be in two locations, in the Rawley River Park Maintenance Facility and in Warren Anko, and that is the construction cost for it.
Okay, strictly construction cost.
Yes.
Freeholder Kowalski.
Yes, following on that question, Director, I would guess that the water is processed or something.
That's correct. Use
the same oily water to wash.
It is recycled and processed to be able to continue to use on further equipment or vehicles. We actually have washdown stations for our larger vehicles. This is for lawnmowers specifically.
So and will you bring, excuse me, will you be bringing us further resolutions then, since this is just for construction? I mean, we'll need an operator as well.
I believe not. This is the construction phase of it, so we should not be coming back for any more.
Freeholder Hudak.
Thank you. Bill number two, the agreement entering into an agreement with Summit and Celgene and the county to install a traffic signal at the headquarters. Who's bearing the cost of that installation?
Celgene themselves.
Okay, so that's 100% funded by Celgene.
That's correct.
Excellent. Thank you.
There's no cost to the county on it's purely for permission purposes.
Any further questions to the Department of Economic Development? None. Thank you.
Thank you.
Department of Human Services, I'll call on County Manager Al Faella to represent the department as Director had an unforeseen family emergency to attend.
Thank you, Chairman. Unfortunately, both the Director and the Deputy Director have had unforeseen family emergencies today. So I will pinch hit and attempt to answer any questions that you may have relative to these resolutions.
Freeholder Hudak.
Chairman, thank you very much. Number one, that's the renewal of the program with the federal government to secure 10 beds at the juvenile facility?
That is correct.
And do we, I mean, I don't know if you happen to have it at your fingertips, but it would, if we can find out from Human Services what the occupancy of that was in 2014. You know, I mean, I know by and large the county makes out in that deal because they don't fill 10 beds regardless of the fact that they pay for them. But always good to know what the stats were for that year. If you have it at your fingertips, great. If not, if you could ask Director Guzzo to get that to us, that would be greatly appreciated.
Through you, Mr. Chairman, I do not have that information, but I will ensure that Director Guzzo provides it for the next meeting.
Thank you, County Manager. Thank you, Chairman.
Any other questions, Board? Thank you. Department of Parks and Recreation, Director Ronald Zuber.
Good evening, Mr. Chairman and Freeholders. Department of Parks and Recreation has four items on tonight's agenda for your consideration, and I'll try to answer any questions that you may have. And if I may, Mr. Chairman, just explain items number one through four in advance. These are four MOUs that we renew every year. This is our fifth year working with the youth golf programs. The focus, as you know, is on golf, but also on life skills. And we allow these groups to access our training facilities and golf courses. And in the past year, we had over 600 participants.
Thank you. Freeholder Mirabella.
Yes, Mr. Chairman, thank you. Director, number five, why do we have to have a resolution authorizing this group to apply for grants? I rarely do I see this kind of thing.
Freeholder, this is a resolution that we do present before the board every year. It just allows.
Yeah, but why?
If I may, through you, Mr. Chairman, the state requires that. This is the very similar to resolution number three from economic development for a grant relative to Sandy. There are certain things that the state requires, and in this case, one of them is to have a resolution approved by the board allowing the county to apply for such grants. It's a state requirement.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
I'm assuming number six is in the same type of scenario?
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
In order to comply with some funding obligation?
That's correct, Mr. Chairman. Right.
Any further questions from the board? Freeholder Granados.
Thank you, Chairman. Just back in reference to number one through four, you said last year it helped out 400 youth, right? You had the numbers for the previous year before that?
Last year was 600 in 2014. 2013, there was 800 kids.
There was a decline?
Yes.
Do we know why there was a decline?
I don't have that answer for you right now.
So we're going to try to aim back for 800 or better this year, I guess?
Absolutely.
Great. Thank you, Chairman.
Thank you. Anything further? Looks like you're good. All right. Department of Public Safety, Andy Moran.
Good evening, Chairman, members of the board. Department of Public Safety has six resolutions on for your consideration. Be happy to answer any questions you may have.
Freeholder Hudak.
Chairman, thank you very much. The 76 firefighters who will be trained under the UASI grant, how many of those are coming from Union County?
About 16 of them.
16? Do you know which municipalities?
Yes, I do. They're all municipalities that house Neptune firefighting equipment, and that would be Elizabeth, Union, Kenilworth, Hillside, Springfield, Rowway, and Linden, along with our Union County hazmat unit.
Thank you, Chairman. Anyone else? Can you tell us about number one and what commitments the county would be committed to as a result of that?
Certainly. As the board is well aware, our car seat program has been at the AAA office on Route 22 in Springfield for several years. It's a very popular program. We inspected over 1,600 car seats last year. AAA has given up that facility, so we had to find a new home for it. The Garwood First Aid Squad offered their facility at a nominal monthly fee, which AAA has agreed to pick up. So it's at no cost
to the county. Cost to the county.
Correct.
Very good. Great. That's a very good program, so I'm glad to know that we'll be able to continue to keep it going.
Thank you.
Vice Chairman Bergen.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Director Moran, number four is an increase of a grant, but doesn't really explain. Can you just tell me briefly what that grant is for?
Certainly. That's our annual CEHA grant, and it is for our environmental enforcement at county level. This increase is because our first notification from the state either had a calculation error or a typographical error, and it was short by 8,000. When we got the clarification from the state, it was 8,000 more. That's why we needed this reso to increase it by that amount.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Anything further? Thank you.
Thank you.
Bless you.
Department of Public Works and Facilities Director Joe Graciano.
Good evening, Chairman, Freeholders. The department has four resolutions on for your consideration tonight. And if I may, number two, three, and four, there's a misprint. I spoke to the clerk before the meeting. They're not supposed to say public bidding. These were exceptions to bidding, it should be stated. Some new rules this year make us all exceptions to bidding. Contracts have to be awarded by resolution. So this is for our utility services for water, gas, and electric for next year's stuff. And it's with Public Service, JCP&L, New Jersey American, and Liberty Water.
Any questions from the board? Thank you.
Thank you, Chairman.
Rental Specialized Hospital, Cornerstone Unit, Michael Fleming, Acting Administrator.
Good evening, Mr. Chairman, members of the board. Rental Specialized Hospital, Cornerstone Unit has one resolution for your consideration. Be happy to answer any questions if you have them.
Thank you. Any questions? Freeholder Hudak.
You know, I don't necessarily have a question for the Acting Administrator in regard to the resolution, but just a general thought and maybe a question in regards to Runnels or the Cornerstone Unit. Is there a reason that Cornerstone has to be maintained as a separate entity, or at some point are we going to consider, reorganization of it as a unit within another department? Has that been entertained at all?
If I may, through you, Mr. Chairman, I've had some preliminary discussions with Director Guzzo and Mr. Drummond, and at some point in the future, we're going to request a policy meeting to discuss that issue.
Okay. I just noticed that Runnels Hospital is coming over. I don't know if it becomes a larger issue in terms of the code, in terms of looking how we refer to things and how resolutions are done. So I imagine at some point we have to address that.
yes, there will be a need to do that, yes.
Thank you. Thank you.
Freeholder Estrada.
Quick question on number one, of course. There's only one there, so that is the one we want to ask questions about. PharmaCare is the same company we used to have at Reynolds before, correct?
Correct.
Now, I think I've asked that question once before a few years ago. I always had an issue or concern about the fact is that we have a fee associated with this when the pharmacy gets a tremendous amount of monies in terms of the sales of the drugs which they're charged to the customers or that we pay for directly, and at the same time they're charging us. Is that, have we gone out to an open public type bid for this process?
There was an RFP for this for the consulting services sent out in December, and this was the only respondent.
Only respondent?
Yeah.
Because, you know, besides the money they make on all the drugs that they dispense, I mean, that should be, I think, sufficient in terms of the monies. But, so there was only one respondent, huh?
Right.
So maybe it'd be beneficial for all of us for you to explain to us exactly what services they provide.
They basically review the medications consumed by the patients and assure the proper medications are being given, dispensed, and also any contraindications, you know, to those medications. And they do put an entry in the patient's chart. In this case, just for the cornerstone units, we anticipate maybe 10 to 15 hours a month, where before, when you had the whole building, it was considerably more than that.
Are people purchasing the pharmaceuticals from them?
No.
Okay.
This is
so they're providing consultation and,
exactly,
and some oversight, I guess, as to
exactly
the drugs that the patients are using.
Correct.
Any additional Freeholder Granados?
Through you, Chairman. One more question. PharmaCare, for the past 3 years, who's the contract been awarded to?
PharmaCare.
Same company, right? And for the past 3 years, nobody else has asked to be a vendor or to be a possible
consider?
I don't
believe so. But this is the only respondent to the RFP.
I think we need to, well, just to make a suggestion also, if we keep seeing that there's only one person coming back with proposal, that we should try to really get out there and see if there's any other companies who might be, you know, more cost-effective when it comes to this. Just a suggestion.
One more question. Do you know how much they billed us last year for the equivalent in terms of for the
entire year last year was $72,000.
$72,000.
Right.
For this contract.
Well, that was for the whole building.
Right,
obviously.
But I'm not saying
yeah
in terms of the contract. I'm saying in terms of how much we consume or we ended up paying for medications to this company.
But they don't provide medications. The medications come from Partners Pharmacy.
Oh, this is not the people that provide the medication?
No. This is a consulting firm with regard to pharmacy.
Wow.
And it's a requirement that we have an independent. Can't have the provider and, you know, provide the consulting services. It's kind of a conflict.
So they consult for the county or they consult for the...
Well, for the county, for Runnels Cornerstone Unit in this case, and ultimately for the county.
Thank you.
Any other questions? Thank you.
Thank you.
Office of the County Council, Robert Barry.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. The Office of the County Council has 9 items on tonight's agenda. I'd be happy to answer any questions the board may have.
Anyone? Questions? Thank you. Freeholder-sponsored resolutions. At this time, I'll ask any freeholder if you have any additional resolutions to add, friendly amendments. Vice Chairman Bergen.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. First of all, with Freeholder Mirabella's permission, I'd like to join him with resolution number 10, and Joe Steiner from Summit Rotary. And also, I will have a resolution to add a laudatory concerning the Union County Baseball Association hot stove dinner
and honoring their four Hall of Fame inductees.
Thank you. Freeholder Kowalski.
Chairman, I might want to join Freeholder Granados on number six, if he would be good enough to share with me whatever info. Thank you.
Yes. Yes.
Two laudatories, well, resolutions I'm going to be requesting, one for approving for progress, which Freeholder Estrada, not sure if you want to join on with that resolution also, and one for Garden State Riders, reference to Special Olympics.
Okay. Anyone else? Freeholder Hudak.
Chairman, just two things. One, on number eight, I may have just a slight change in the language on that resolution, just fortunately, the Port Authority is tabled for the moment, the path termination, but I still want to continue to put the resolution on to memorialize that they shouldn't eliminate path service overnight. And secondly, as a result of fiscal, we will likely have a couple of resolutions for next week's agenda, and we'll get those to the clerk.
Great. Anything else? All right. County Council, can you make your statement relative to tonight's executive session?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Pursuant to the provisions of the Open Public Meetings Act, public body may enter into executive session for the purposes of discussing certain enumerated subjects. This board now wishes to enter into executive session for the purpose of discussing attorney-client privilege communication regarding potential litigation relative to the new county courthouse. In addition, attorney-client privilege communication and discussions as to potential settlement in the matter of HC Equities versus the County of Union, and finally, potential contract negotiations relative to a potential professional service contract with the County Alliance. The minutes of the executive session shall be separated from the minutes of the open public session. Minutes of the executive session, redacted as appropriate and necessary, shall be available in approximately 30 days. The clerk to the board shall retain the original minutes until such time as the confidential limitations have been removed, at which time they shall be made available. Upon the affirmative vote of a majority of the members present, the board may enter into executive session. Upon the board's return, given this is an agenda meeting, it will not take any action on the matters discussed.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
We have a motion to enter into executive session.
So moved.
Second.
Moved by Freeholder Mirabella, seconded by Freeholder Hudak. Clerk of the board may have a roll call.
Freeholder Carter?
Yes.
Freeholder Estrada?
Yes.
Freeholder Granados?
Aye.
Freeholder Hudak?
Aye.
Freeholder Kowalski?
Yes.
Freeholder Mirabella?
Aye.
Freeholder Wright?
Yes.
Vice Chairman Bergen?
Aye.
Chairman Jalloh?
Aye.
Chairman, you have 9 votes in the affirmative.
Executive session.
Sorry, that was Freeholder Mirabella and seconded by Freeholder Carter.
Yes.
Okay, Freeholder Carter.
Yes.
Freeholder Estrada.
Yes.
Freeholder Granados.
Aye.
Freeholder Hudak.
Aye.
Freeholder Kowalski.
Yes.
Freeholder Mirabella.
Aye.
Freeholder Wright.
Yes.
Vice Chairman Bergen.
Yes.
Chairman Jalloh.
Aye.
Chairman, you have 9 votes in the affirmative.
All right. County Council, do you have any statements to make?
No statement necessary. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you. I'll take a motion to adjourn.
So moved. Second. Aye.
All in favor?
Aye.
Good first meeting, Chairman. Yes. Well done.